DuckTales Episode 20.
The legendary Cornelius Coot.
Hmm? Is he a character that I should know from the old comics? I wonder.
Single-handedly saved this very fort, stamped himself upon our history.
Oh god, history lesson. My favorite.
Well, Coot's descendant, Deladuck, will skywrite the letter C to commemorate him.
Just a C? Uncle Scrooge charges by the letter.
Oh, ow. Oh my god. Come on, Scrooge. This culture stuff is important for some people. Buttermilk? Oh, you mean like in no Harry Potter that was butter. Butter.
Hey guys,
beer? Okay.
I
skip.
Yeah.
Yay! What fun!
And I'm bored.
Yeah, 2 minutes later. No, not even 2 seconds later. That's me at every cultural historical event ever.
The Beagles weren't just after the fort. They were after the golden armory of Cornelius.
The Beagles being the Beagle Boys, like they're, you know, the people that came before them. Ah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they are.
Not if I get there first.
Hey, Della! Nice to see you! It's good that you are here.
Oh.
Oh, no. Ah, you two have a rivalry now. I mean, mostly infuriated by her.
Just need to find Spinny Boy.
Spinny Boy?
Spinny Boy? Okay, that's your name for that thing.
Most historians consider this stuff to be a myth.
But we're gonna set things right. Force the tour guide to give up the goods and reclaim the treasure of Fort Beagleburg!
Better start worrying about, I don't know, some bank or so. That's more interesting to me, at least.
We're gonna have to go in a different direction.
Mm-hmm.
A non-failure direction.
Wow.
You're a failure as a criminal, a vegan, and a son.
Boah.
What are you trying to
leave
say?
The fucking family and work for, I don't know, Scrooge? I don't think that would work, but I feel kind of bad for him, even though he's a bad guy and I'm not supposed to. Then again, I think I am actually supposed to feel a bit of empathy here. Oh. Interesting. There's actually some space under there. Okay, now it's a treasure hunt. That's more interesting to me than just making things right from the past because of your family or whatever. That's really something that I don't give a shit about. Wow. Interesting. That's cool. Okay. Oh no, now he has to prove himself to her. Yeah, I gotta do it myself and blah, proof, blah, blah.
It's big time's time to make a name for himself.
It's big time, it's big time.
Make that buttermilk for the rope.
I did it. I found a photo of what the plane is supposed to look like, so we can piece it together. Let's start from the corner.
Wow. Okay, the rivalry doesn't seem to be that strong anymore. It was only there for one episode then. She seems to be kind of okay with him. I mean, not to be the biggest fan. Understandably so, but I mean, I do like him, of course, but as a competent pilot and all of that. But yeah, she seems to also be okay with the fact that she has to co-work with him.
Oh, I use gum.
Ah, what? Oh god, how stupid can one be? No! Oh god, he has to be fired.
Is that a hamster wheel?
Yeah.
What?
Obviously, a gerbil couldn't spin the propeller.
Oh god.
Cool, so this is our tomb.
Mm hmm. Okay, this episode's premise and all of that's not my thing, but the jokes are funny. They're good.
Oh, Peat Moss, ingenious!
Uh-huh.
All we have to do is push ever so slightly and...
Oh, shit! Well, what was that?
It doesn't taste mossy enough to be moss.
I don't want to know what it is.
Oh, dear.
Ah! Yo! The fuck? Oh, what the? Oh god, I would say run, but that's not the solution, I guess.
She's smiling. Happy
oh.
Plane, happy plane.
Is that a callback to anything?
Don't. Paint's still wet. Don't, because I don't want you near my plane at all.
Don't breathe.
Sorry, it's not personal. It's just that.
I hate you.
You know you're a bad pilot, right? Not only Aww. In the sense that you crash every time you fly.
Co-pilot!
What? No.
I spoke from the best.
Yes.
How do I say yes without agreeing to this?
Wow. Yeah, you have no luck with this guy. Just come on, just give up and just show him. No. Aww. He will grow on you eventually.
I want to go home.
Oh God.
Yeah, this adventure's a bust.
Ah, come on. She seems to be onto something here. Oh my God. Okay. So, okay. How will that work out? I thought kind of sad for a second. I thought they would interact, but apparently not. Not yet, at least. Ah, poor Big Time. Maybe cooperate for once. You bigger guys must have some strength that could come in handy somehow.
You've got your altimeter, right? Tachometer. That's the airspeed indicator. You've gone 5,000 miles. Why don't you just
wow.
stare out the window to make sure we're still in the air?
Still in the air.
Oh God, you should really teach this still guy one or two things. How did they not already die with him as a pilot? Oh, Louis, come on. Your help is needed. And what Dewey?
Shh. Just relax. Turn your mind off. Just gaze.
Okay, can we find anything that can make you to bond? Because that's
it's 6 tons of metal in the air that important. I just had to completely reassemble. Just sit over there and don't distract me.
She's done for.
Ben, are we still here? I had this amazing dream that we weren't.
What happened to Big Time?
Uh-oh.
A few more steps, and we'll have made it farther than anyone!
Okay.
If we solve this, we can be as
but how come that nobody ever made it farther than this Mission point?
Webby. This is it! The Golden Armory!
Treasure!
Adventure!
Ooh!
Accuracy.
Okay. So, actually, everybody should have gone further from this point on. Doesn't make any sense that nobody did. What? Woo! Oh, an actual treasure! Wait a second. The shape is a bit weird. Oh, what?
No,
corn? Oh God! Is that the treasure of Pocahontas?
System for storing corn. Those weren't mine carts; they were corn carts.
Oh.
And those markers we found along the way were just farm tools.
Worst treasure hunt ever!
Ah, come on! Corn has value—not the same value as
Sorry,
gold,
buddy.
Of
it's
course.
Over.
But
let's go home.
He saved the fort. How did he stop
yeah,
the people?
I guess you
and
might be losing
are
it, actually.
You gonna get out of this alive?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Oh, here they are, your besties.
Oh.
Especially the grandma. I really don't like the grandma's hair shape here, the round shape, because it doesn't look like hair that much than a kind of a gray bag that she has here. And the shape that Webby has, where it's a bit more pointy and edgy, that is better as hair. Her shape just looks like a bunch of bananas or so. Okay. What? Oh, nice combination of those two stories.
Leave it to Mom to make the lamest adventure ever awesome.
Go, Mom.
I thought you were at the fort.
We are never going to get out of here.
You got that right.
Uh-oh, they're still Big Time.
Big Time?
Nope. Made a name for myself, Ma. I'm Bug Time now.
Bug Time? Oh shit, that's a nice power if he
There's
keeps that one.
But look at everything you did by the time you were my age. I could never stack up.
Are you sure that was your age?
You. I accomplished corn.
Aww.
I'm an imposter, just like Coot.
Okay,
no
stop with that self
no
bullshit.
But you did accomplish something.
Yeah.
You made it farther than anyone else has.
Yeah.
You don't have
yeah?
to be me.
Yeah.
You just have to be Webby. And you have your own way of doing things. You don't have to prove yourself to anyone. And
run.
I should really apologize to Launchpad.
Yeah. Wow. Oh, interesting. popcorn.
This was Coot's armory. He turned his corn into popcorn and convinced the Beagles that he was an entire army.
Oh.
Using his wits.
Interesting. Whoa. Nice.
I guess he was a hero in his own way.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, too much popcorn.
Moron, see how she talks to me, Tarantula? But I got no need to impress her. Nobody can stop the Boggle Boys.
That's too cool to stop in this episode. It would be cool if that kind of sticks.
Ghost Army,
but I think it won't. Bugs don't stand a chance against this.
hold your breath.
You're saving them, actually? Wow. They're still family, I guess.
We can't back up. Launchpad, do your thing.
Okay.
Give me a boost.
Let's see. Oh, what? Okay, what did you feed that thing with? Steroids? Okay, crash out of this?
Fine, you're back in the gang.
Oh.
I got old popcorn stuck.
I would leave
teeth.
The family,
don't
but.
Worry, Ma. Them's just spider eggs.
What? Oh god. No, I don't want to feel empathy for her. I don't like my beaker. Serves her right.
And Coot used the farm tools as arrows to point the way.
Come get your commemorative Coot popcorn.
Oh wow, okay, now we have more accuracy in those things here. Cheers. Still doesn't taste good. Not the best episode in my opinion, but I had fun. I can't complain. Yeah, moving on. Shout out to my coffee supporters and shout out to my patrons. That's it. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. See you in the next one. See you on the other side. Andy out. Bye.